Hey guys, Jeffro here from Ruthless TV. I'm here with Andrew. He's come all the way over from New Zealand for the Adelaide Three Eyes Tattoo Convention. How you doing, Andrew?
Yeah, good, man. Yeah, great.
Excellent.
Great, yeah.
What do you think of the convention so far?
Loving it, eh? It's really, really good. Really geared towards the artist more than anything else. I really like
that. They're definitely looking after their artists and boys. It's really cool.
I really like it.
Tell us a little bit about your studio back home.
Home, Lipton Park Tattoos. We're in Christchurch, New Zealand. It's in an old Freemasons lodge, so it's like this cool old building, and it's about, I think there's five of us work there now. So everyone sort of specialises their own stuff. We really try to push everyone's own style.
Yep.
I really enjoy doing what I like doing, so I try to encourage everyone that works for me to do the same thing. We all really just sort of bounce ideas off each other.
There's definitely, seems to be a lot more of that going on rather than the average street shop where everybody does everything.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you think the industry's changed, you know, over the last 5 years? What's the biggest change that you've seen?
The biggest change I've seen is people coming out of the gate specialising.
Yep.
It's awesome, like some of them are just shockingly good, and to say a bad word about that would just be, it would just be wrong in my opinion. Like for me, my apprentices and stuff, when I pull them through, it doesn't matter how good at one style they are, I try to make sure they're well-rounded and everything.
Yeah.
Because some of the stuff that I learned doing styles of tattoos that I don't enjoy, I use every day.
Yeah.
The stuff that I do, it's the stuff I learned from slogging away at that shit I hate.
Yeah.
You know, that really helps, like that one today. There's nice big power lines around the outside. I fucking hate lining, but it needed it. And so I could draw on that ability to be able to do it, and that's what I want him to be able to do. So
that's brilliant.
I think he might miss out a bit if he just doing the same stuff.
Yeah, perfect. Who are you watching? Who's really doing it?
Yeah, I mean, Dimitri Samoane, probably. Yeah. I mean, you can't. Every time you think he's gone, another one comes up and you're like, but I like that social media aspect of it. I remember having to wait for the latest magazine to come out.
Yeah.
It was only two those people chose that they liked, and now you can pick what you like and follow it every single day.
Yep.
Straight away. You can communicate directly with them.
Yeah.
It's great, you know. I think a lot of the innocence of the industry has been lost. But at the end of the day, the art's won. The clients won.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
There's so much better stuff out there.
Dead right.
And if you're feeling butthurt about it, then suck it up and do better, you know? Like, I've had to really pull finger this year, you know? And it works out. You put that effort in, you know?
Yeah.
Really it does work out.
Yeah, you're right. Mate, setup, general setup.
V2. I use mainly Eternal Link.
Yeah.
And that's mainly for an availability in New Zealand. Everything we import has cost a lot of money. So I use some Dynamic. I use a bit of Ala Prima. I use anything, any colour that I like that goes into the S-box. Everything else goes from there. But the injectors. I borrowed one a couple of years ago from a guy that worked for me, and I was like, oh, this is bullshit, so I have to get one of these now. And just the ease of plug and play.
Yeah.
Get it the same every day.
Yeah, yeah.
Chuck a cord up the guts of it, and away you go. You
know, okay.
I've got a drawer full of coils. I know how to build them. I know how to tune them. It's not like I can't do that shit. I just choose to not have to.
That's right.
Right.
Yeah, ease ability.
Yeah, man. I mean, like, I remember I'd go and see some of my idols, you know, before the advent of like the really popularity of the non-coil machine, and they'd have like 10 coil machines set up, you know, and they'd be swapping them between them all the time, like a set of brushes, and I was like, oh, I wish I could do that, you know, and now one machine you can.
Yeah. That's right.
Do it on the same machine. And I don't change the voltage, I don't change anything between lining and shading.
Yeah. Especially with cartridges now, it's unreal.
It's nuts. And you can. You just line up a bunch of cartridges.
Yeah, crazy. Yeah. Your style, mate, explain it to us. What would you call your style?
Colour surrealism, I suppose. A lot of Dali, a lot of Greg Simpkins, Crayola Simpkins. Coming from a background as a kid and a teenager, I really wanted to be a real artist. You know, I wanted to do illustration, I wanted to do movie maps, I wanted to do stuff like that. My influences mainly come from outside of people.
Yep.
I love seeing people just really take what they do and just run sideways with it.
Yeah.
And I think the tattooists that stand out are the ones that do that. They're not pumping out exactly the same stuff all the time. Every now and then you'll see a new piece come out of someone and you just wouldn't expect it from them.
Yeah. Yeah, that's cool. Okay, Andrew, awesome chat, mate.
No worries.
Really, really glad. Thank you very much.
No worries.
Cheers, mate.
Awesome, thank you.